Hello everyone, welcome once again to our lecture series. So this is our 10th lecture on moment of inertia. Till now we have gone through some 16 odd numericals. So in this lecture we will see the next numerical, okay, the 17th numerical. So what does this numerical states? Calculate radius of gyration of channel section at centroidal axis xx. So they have given the diagram and they have asked us to find out the radius of gyration. Okay, so when radius of gyration is to be found, remember, when radius of gyration is to be found, we need to find the moment of inertia also, as we have discussed during our theory lecture on this particular topic, that when we need to find radius of gyration, we need to find moment of inertia. Why? Because radius of gyration is equal to square root of moment of inertia upon area of the plane. Okay, so channel section, they have mentioned the channel section over here, but channel section does not look like a C, it looks like a U. Even though it looks like a U, it is a channel section because it is just a different placement of the channel section. Okay, so the channel section is placed differently, hence it is a channel section. We will consider it as a channel section only. Okay, now what we will do over here, we will draw a horizontal line like this and like this. Okay. So we'll consider this as the first rectangle, this is our second rectangle, and this is our third rectangle. Okay, so from that we will take the dimensions. So what is the breadth of our first rectangle? The breadth of our first rectangle, that is B1, is 90 mm. The depth of first rectangle, that is D1, is equal to 10 mm. The breadth of second rectangle, that is B2, is equal to 8 mm. And the depth of second rectangle, that is D2, is equal to 40 mm. Similarly, B3 is also 8 mm and D3 is also 40 mm. These two rectangles are same, they are equidistant as well as they are same. Okay, so we'll write the given quantities, and while to find we will write IXX and KXX. Remember here that only KXX we have to find. They have given us that to find the radius of gyration at channel section at centroidal axis XX. Okay, so for that, to find the moment of inertia about centroidal axis XX, we need to find IXX, so I have written here KXX. If you don't write here IXX, then too it is okay. But KXX you have to find. So to find KXX, you should know that you have to find IXX. So for that very reason, I have written here IXX. Okay. So first what we will do, we will find IXX. We will calculate the whole area of this plane. And then we will move for KXX. Okay. So let's begin. So as you know, from all the last examples from that experience, you know that IXX is what? When different planes are there, when they are added to one another, then we add the moment of inertia of those individual planes. So IXX is what? IX is equal to IXX1 plus IXX2 plus IXX3. Okay, now remember in the last question I have told you that the C section was symmetrical about the horizontal centroidal axis. But in this case, your C section or the channel section given over here is not symmetrical about the horizontal centroidal axis. Why? If you draw a horizontal line at its center, suppose this is 40 mm, this is 10 mm, you draw a horizontal centroidal line or any horizontal line at 25 mm, why? As total height is 50, half of that will be 25. If you draw at 25, you will find that the upper section and the lower section are not same. So the plane is not symmetrical. So for that reason, we need to find y bar. So what is the value of y bar? The formula for y bar is a1 y1 plus a2 y2 plus a3 y3 upon a1 plus a2 plus a3. So a1 is area of first rectangle, so it is b1 d1. So we'll have b1 into d1 as 900 mm. So area for first rectangle is 900 mm. Area of second rectangle, that is b2 into d2, so 8 into 40, we'll have a2 as 320 mm. Then A3, that is B3 into D3, the area of third rectangle, and that will be also equal to 320 mm. What is Y1? Y1 is the location of the horizontal central axis of the first plane from bottom. So that will be D1 by 2. Okay, so that will be 5 mm, as a D1 is 10. Then Y2 will be the position of the second or the position of the horizontal centroidal axis of the second plane with respect to the bottom. So our second plane begins from 10 mm above the bottom, So 10 plus 40 by 2 will give us 30 mm. Similarly, our y3 will be equal to 10 plus 40 by 3. Why? Because the distance over here is same. The distance, this 10 mm is same here also and here also. And the height for section 2 and section 3 are same. So y3 is equal to 10 plus d3 by 2, and that will give us 30 mm. So now we have y1, y2 and y3 also. Okay, in addition to a1, a2 and a3. So a1, a2, a3, y1, y2, y3. Having all these terms, we can find out y bar. So y bar is equal to a1 y1 plus a2 y2 plus a3 y3 upon a1 plus a2 plus a3. Putting the values over there, we will get y bar is equal to 900 into 5 plus 320 into 3 plus 320 into 30 plus 320 into 30 upon 900 plus 320 plus 320. When we solve all this, we will get y bar is equal to 15.3896 mm. So this is our y bar. So y bar is where? Y bar is at a distance of 15.3896 mm. So the position of the horizontal central axis or the x-axis of the whole plane from bottom part or from the bottommost edge is how much? 15.3896. Now the y bar is calculated. Now what is remaining? Now we have to find ixx I, and then kxx. To find ixx, we need to find ixx1. So what is ixx1? ixx1 is the moment of inertia of the first plane. It is the moment of inertia of our first plane about the horizontal central axis of the whole plane. Okay, so here too, like our previous examples, we will use the parallaxis theorem, and by using parallaxis theorem we will have ixx1 is equal to b1 d1 cube upon 12 plus a1 h1 square. Again here h1 will be equal to y bar minus y1. Using all those things we will get ixx1 as 104.6494 into 10 raised to 3. Okay, remember the method to find ixx1 here is same as that we found in the last question or the last some questions. Okay, same way ixx2 is equal to how much? Again, ixx2 is moment of inertia of the second plane about the horizontal central axis of the whole plane, that is about axis xx. So as our axis xx and the horizontal central axis of the second plane and third plane are parallel, here too we will use the parallaxis theorem. By using parallaxis theorem we will have ixx2 is equal to b2 d2 cube upon 12 plus a1 h2 square. Here h2 is equal to y bar minus y2. Putting the values of b2, d2, a2 and h2, finally we will get ixx2. So we have now ixx1 and ixx2. Now we need to find ixx3. What is ixx3? ixx3 is moment of inertia of third plane with respect to the horizontal central axis of our whole plane. Okay, so as the central axis of the third plane is parallel to the central axis of the whole plane, that is ixx is parallel to 3 3, we will use parallaxis theorem here also, and we will have ixx3 is equal to b3 d3 cube upon 12 plus a3 h3 square. Here h3 is equal to y bar minus y3. Now remember here that why in all examples we are using the formula of bd cube upon 12, because the sections or the separate planes that we have are rectangular in shape. Okay, and the moment of inertia or the formula for moment of inertia of rectangle about its horizontal central axis is bd cube upon 12. That's why we are using the formula b1 d1 cube upon 12, b2 d2 cube upon 12 and b3 d3 cube upon 12 likewise. Okay, again putting these values we'll get ixx3. So ixx3 is equal to 110.9750. So as you can see over here, ixx2 and ixx3 are same. Okay, now you know the reason behind that I have explained you in the previous example. Okay, if again you have doubt regarding the reason why ixx2 and ixx3 are same, please go through the diagram. Again, please go through the last question of our last lecture, that is of our 9th lecture of moment of inertia. Okay, I think now you have now gained the knowledge how to find IXS1, IXS2 and IXS3. Now proceeding further, we'll find the value of IXX. So what is IXX? IXX is addition of all these three terms. So adding all those three terms, what we will get? IXX is equal to 326.5995 × 10³ mm³². Okay, we have added IXX1 to IXX2 and IXX3. Okay, by adding all these three terms, we will get IXX1 and that is equal to 326.5995 × 10³ mm³². Okay, now what is remaining? We have to find KXX. So to find KXX, so this is K, okay, this is not L, this is K. So KXX is equal to how much? It is equal to square root of IXX upon A. Now we have IXX, we need to find A. What is A? A is the area. Area of what? Area of the whole plane. So how much elements are there for this area? We have the first element, that is first rectangle. We have second element, the second rectangle. And the third element, that is our third rectangle. Now to find the area of this whole plane, we need to add the area of the individual sections or the area of the individual planes. So we have to add A1, A2 and A3. By adding A1, A2 and A3, we will get A and that is equal to 1540 mm². Why? Because A1 was 900, A2 was 320 and A3 was also 320. By adding 900 to 320, we will get 1540 mm². Now putting the value of A and IXX in this formula, we'll get KXX is equal to square root of 326.5995 × 10³ upon 1540. And finally, we'll have KXX as 14.5628 mm. Okay. So, what was different in this question than the previous one or from the previous lecture? The position of channel section was different first, and second, instead of just asking for the moment of inertia at horizontal centroidal axis, they have asked us to find the value of KXX. That is, they have asked us to find the value of radius of gyration at the horizontal centroidal axis. Okay, so you need to know that to find the value of radius of gyration at horizontal centroidal axis, first you need to find the value of moment of inertia at horizontal centroidal axis. So we'll go through that manner. First we'll find IXX and then whole area of that plane, and proceeding further we can find the value of KXX. Okay, so this was our example, today's example. Okay, now remember, as we have gone through numerous examples, now you should be well acquainted with how to solve the problems of moment of inertia. Okay, now only one section is remaining and that is our I section. So numericals might be on symmetric I section or a symmetric I section. We will follow those numericals in our coming lectures. Okay, so again, if you have any doubt regarding this lecture or our previous 10 lectures or any lectures that you have learned through our online learning system of this particular subject, that is of strength of materials, please go through our description box, please go to our Telegram channel and please post your difficulties or doubts over there. Again, various lecture notes and these PPTs will be uploaded on Telegram, so you can download from there and you can solve it by your own. Okay, and remember, again, while I am teaching you this particular example or in any lecture, please try to write the question. Hit the pause button, write the question, write the steps. Okay, so that you could understand what exactly or how exactly to solve the numericals of moment of inertia. Okay, so that's it. That's all for today. Okay, meet you again in the next lecture. Thank you.